r/AskReddit. Married men of Reddit. What was that dumb thing you did during your dating phase that you can't believe your wife ended up overlooking? My uncle didn't call his now wife for over a year after they first met, and he got her number. He kept the paper she wrote it on, and ended up finding it, and calling her asking if she still remembered him, and was still interested in going on a date. Insisted that everything in San Francisco was walking distance from everything else, and decided we should walk from Pier 39 to Golden Gate Park. It is walkable, but not third date walkable, or whatever shoes she happened to be wearing that day walkable. For our second date, I had invited her out with myself and some friends to celebrate a friend getting a job. I drank heavily. She was my DD. She drove me home, and as she pulled up to the curb, I threw open the door, rolled out of the car, and vomited into the gutter. She then offered to help me cross the street, to which I responded by yelling I'm disgusting and sprinting across the street. Once inside, I brushed my teeth aggressively. She asked what I was doing, and I told her I needed to clean my mouth so I could kiss her. After I was done, I walked to my room, laid down, and immediately fell asleep. She spent the night to make sure I was okay. I'm now holding our baby girl who was born just last week. I asked her at one point why she stayed with me through that, and she said it was because even though I was best drunk the whole time, I was still gentle and kind. Asked her if she was having fun, and introduced her to everyone I knew. I'm a lucky guy. We drank a lot on our second date, Ubered home. Next day went back to get his car, and it wasn't there. He was so devastated. He just bought it recently, and it was stolen. We filed a police report. Took forever and just generally sucked. We walked to his friend's house nearby, and there was his car, perfectly unstolen. He drank so much he forgot he moved it before our date. Now, once in a while, when we're trying to find our car in the grocery store parking lot or wherever, one of us will say it's stolen. Call the police. Flicked a dime at her head. We were playing table football. Not sure what I was thinking. She has a scar. I kiss it every night before we go to bed. We are married and have 3 kids. Accidentally set her hair on fire with a match while lighting a cigarette. Not good. We are still married 29 years later. I don't smoke anymore. When I kneeled to propose, I landed on a sharp rock, and we had to go to the earth because it lodged in my kneecap. Edit. Wow. Did not expect us to get so many upvotes. My wife demands I make a minor correction to adequately embarrass myself. She said that I can't tell the story and leave out her absolute favorite detail because of the kneecap situation. I forgot to actually ask. She thought I got nervous and froze up and decided to save me by just saying yes. She also stopped me from pulling the rock out of my kneecap with my trusty Leatherman, which turned out to be the correct decision. She was a little bummed that I wasn't simply choked with emotion, but the situation as a whole is now a very fond memory. Side note, driving a manual transmission with a rock sticking out of one's kneecap is not super fun. She was about to sneeze, and she was sitting half on my lap, so I kinda thought she was gonna sneeze on me, and I DK what I was thinking, but I put my hand up to block her sneeze, except I had a glass in my hand and I blocked her own hand from covering her sneeze, and instead she slammed her face into my glass. Married 6 years now, she still has all her teeth. I once spear tackled my then girlfriend out of misplaced enthusiasm in high school. I was excited to see her, and handled it as badly as was possible. It was in front of a bunch of our friends and I ended up knocking the wind out of her, and making her cry. That was about 17 years ago, and we are still together. I also licked my plate at a fancy restaurant, because the salad dressing was so good. She still brings that one up every few years. On our first dinner date, my husband ordered a ton of food to show me his favorites at an Indian restaurant, and forgot his wallet at home, and only discovered doing so when the check had arrived. Cleared me out well over $100, and he was absolutely mortified, but we've been married for near 2 years so. My husband broke my thumb one night when we were slightly tipsy. Horseplay got too rough and I think, drunk memory, he slammed my hand against something. We both heard the pop, and I went to tears. I was sitting on the couch as we were playing Wii Bowling. She was standing behind the couch, lovingly holding me. I draw back the Wiimote and wham. I whack her in the face with the Wiimote at full strength. Her mom was also in the room. We were taking a shower together, and she was soaping up, while I was under the hot water rinsing off, and she slipped, and instead of grabbing slash helping her I pulled away, thinking for some reason, that I'd already rinsed off, and didn't want to get soapy. Thank God she caught herself on the shower curtain, and didn't get hurt. She was, not happy. My explanation of my faulty thinking, didn't help at all either. We laugh about it now, but it took some serious smoothing over at the time. I made myself a burger for dinner, before heading over to her place to hang out. Unfortunately I'm not the best cook, and left a little too much pink in that burger. While we were at her house I bet her I could fit through the doggy door, and crawled right through. Then she immediately closed it behind me, and we raced to the front door. She won and she locked it. Now at this exact moment my bowels decided they had enough of that burger from earlier, and I felt my stomach cramp. Luckily I held it all in, and ran back to the back door with my cheeks clenched, and starting knocking desperately in the door. She was laughing at first, but when she saw my face go suddenly serious, and I said very calmly I need you to open the door. Now please. She unlocked the door, and asked if I was okay. I told her to stay downstairs and turn the TV up loud. She agreed but was very confused. So I ran upstairs, and then had one of the most violent S of my whole life. I thought the worst was behind me, until I went to wipe, and of course no TP. So she took my instructions really well, and when I yelled to her, texted her, and called her I got no answer. After probably like 10 missed calls she finally answered, and I asked her to bring me some TP and leave outside the door, and try not to breathe on the way upstairs. She was great about it, and immediately started making fun of me when I came back downstairs. Now quite a few years later a couple kids and cat, she's still making fun of me. When we were dating, my husband and I were holding hands, when he had to cough. Instead of letting go of my hand, and covering his mouth, he continued to hold on, brought it up to his mouth, and coughed into my hand. It was a dry cough. If it was anything more I would have run. I had just started a job working with her, and, unbeknownst to me at the time, her mom and I did not get along. My move was what's up with that thick, insert name. She said oh, I'll tell my mom you said hi. I point was dead. But hey here's we are married 16 years so. We were making out in her dorm. I was on top and I, my pants. I know what my husband would say, because I still tease him to this day. We had been dating for 2 weeks, and were spooning on his futon, watching a movie. Out of nowhere he says, I'm really sorry, I can't hold it in anymore. And rips a huge fart. My husband was a very clean, tight-knit, prudish kind of guy, so I couldn't help but let out the biggest laugh, while he turned about as red as his beard. The night I met my husband, he stared at me while I was sleeping for 4 hours straight. It's been 3 years. He still stares at me until I scold him for it. Then he waits until he thinks I won't notice and starts staring again. I love him to the moon and back, even though he'd sure as stare at me the entire trip. First date with my wife. End of the night I went to kiss her on the cheek being all sweet and she thought I was leaning in for a hug, and leaned in too. As she leaned and I turned my head, and instead of her cheek I kissed her neck. Turned super red, and embarrassed and goodbye and almost pushed her out of the door at my apartment. I immediately texted her sorry as well and she laughed. 3 years into marriage she apparently didn't care. Wife here, but about 3 weeks into dating, my husband invited me to a house party at his best friend's place. We were playing beer pong having fun. The other team is up, they toss the ball. I lean forward to try to block it. My now husband extends his hand out in front of me at the same time, catching the ball, but at the same time hitting me in the eye and somehow pulling out 3/4 of my eyelashes. He felt terrible about it, and tried to burn off his eyelashes in drunken sympathy. He hates when I bring it up, but I think it is the funniest story. On my first date with my wife, we got to talking about tattoos. I have a rule that, if I have an idea for a tattoo, I sit on it for a while to see if I really would still want it. I mentioned this to her, and explain how glad I am that I do this, because otherwise I'd be covered in tool, the band, tattoos or some other dumb. She rolled up her sleeve to show me that she had the lyrics to one of their songs tattooed across her arm. It wasn't until after we were married that my wife told me that I almost didn't get a second date because I talked way too much during the movie. I don't really remember it, but apparently I was leaning over every 30 seconds or so to tell her what I was thinking. Also, Valkyrie with Tom Cruise probably wasn't that great of a date movie, but it all worked out in the end. Eta, please forgive me my movie talking sense, everybody. I was a dumb teenager and she's really pretty. I was just quite anxious for things to go well. My husband kept calling me by the name of his previous girlfriend on our first date. I finally told him to give her a call, because they clearly had unfinished business to talk about. He did and she reminded him why he was happy to have her out of his life. And he never called me by her name again 40 years later, and it seems to have worked out in my favor.